Now to present the next two awards, the editor-in-chief of the Harvard Business Review, our dear friend, a disruptive fellow, Mr. Adi Ignatius.
So 2 years ago, Harvard Business Review joined with the Tribeca Disruptive Innovations Award to create an annual prize for Clay Christensen, who, as Craig said, is the inspiration for this entire event. We bestowed that initial prize on Clay himself. We even thought about giving it to him every year, and while Clay would have probably respected the efficiency of that, we figured that at a certain point it would have seemed lazy. Luckily, we have another deserving winner this year, Jennifer Hyman. Jennifer came up with the idea for Rent the Runway, sitting in Clay Christensen's very class at Harvard Business School. Inherently a disruptive sharing economy concept, Rent the Runway wasn't going to be about renting clothes, it was going to be about renting experiences and provoking transformation. By helping women see themselves differently, they become empowered. Today, we're very proud to give Jennifer the Christensen Prize, as I said, named for the founder of disruptive innovation theory. Ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer Hyman. So I guess my question, I mean, it now seems like an amazing idea, but I want to ask you, at what point did you realize, wow, I've really got a viable business concept here?
Well, I think that renting fashion for a mass market price point was something that rationally made sense, but the moment where I felt like it was actually going to be a movement was in a test that we ran while we were at Harvard Business School. We were taught by Clay to go after the minimum viable product and to actually see the results. We launched a test where we brought in inventory to hundreds of young women who were attending college, and we saw a young woman run across the room, spot a dress, strip in front of several hundred people, put on this sparkly dress, and kind of turn to her friend and say, "I look so hot." And I saw that there was something really emotional to her about this confidence boost that she got when she got access to something that for her whole life she had been taught to aspire to, but had never been able to afford until then. And I think that largely we're educating a global population of people to aspire to a life that 99% of the world can't afford. And fashion is actually one of those key categories, especially for women, where we derive a lot of our sense of self-worth. So it's been a pleasure to be able to serve millions of women and help them before moments in their life just have that extra little boost of feeling like the best version of themselves.
All right, it's amazing. Congratulations.
Thank you.